long as you can get far.
Things that my friends and family have had to adapt to since I became a witch.
Where are all the spices?
What was that? You look stressed. Do you want a little bag full of herbs and some pretty crystals? It'll make you feel better, I promise. Oh, I wouldn't go in there right now.
Why's that?
I think she's in the middle of like a ritual or something.
Can you please stop bullying me for 1 second?
Hey, I found a candle for you. Do you want it?
Ooh, yes.
Okay, I'll go put it in your room.
Make sure you put it on Apollo's altar.
Why are you drinking out of a tequila bottle? It's moon water, I swear.
Yeah, my deities were yelling at me because I tried to text my ex.
I'm with your deities on this one. I'll whoop your ass if you try to text them. Hey, Kelsey, we have another empty jar. Do you want it? Never mind, I'm not even gonna ask. I know you want it.
Why does she have so much energy right now?
It's the full moon tonight. I'd get ready.
All right, so these are all my plants and they're all my children.
Spiritual cat facts. Cats' auras expand more than ours, so they use it to protect us. Cats have a protective property about them. They can sense good or bad energies off of people. They can also sense negative auras and can tell us when something is negative in our home. They can sense evil presences. It is said that if your cat is chasing something outside that you can't see, then they're probably playing with the fae. Cats have a high vibrational field, so they usually match with humans who match that energy. Cats are picky on who they trust because they can sense your frequencies. Since cats have protective properties about them, they can use their aura to protect and heal you also. So it is said that cats can keep negative energies out of your home. Many Buddhists have said that they meditate with their cats and the results are remarkable. Some even say that cats are temporary resting places for spiritual beings, and that may even be why you catch your cat meditating a lot. For years, cats have been known as spiritually enlightened animals who can sense the spiritual world.
I put a spell on you, and now you're mine. You can't stop the things I do. I ain't lying.
Oh my god, is that a heart?
accidentally left my moon water in the sun, meaning I have created a new water called space water. Its properties include helping you not cry during finals.
People think I'm obsessed with this, but I'm okay with it. I am obsessed with it. And I think this is an obsession that doesn't hurt anyone.
Lego.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that mine?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
I don't understand why you keep laughing.
You're doing it so well.
Thank you. I didn't come here to fuck around. Do you think I can get like glue poisoning? Because I just realized that I'm going to have to cover my entire face in glue. Like, is this bad for you?
Yeah, that's probably fine.
If you are not of love and light, you are not welcome here. Thank you for your presence, but it's time to go home. All right, buckos, you know the drill. Who's not supposed to be here?
Hi, TikTok. Good morning. Let's talk about crystals today. Yes, please. Thank you. Yes, let's talk about crystals. Let's talk about them.
There are quite a few people that come into the shop that I work at looking for a crystal that's going to help with fertility, looking for a crystal that's going to help heal a broken leg. And I hate to break it to you, but that is like quack science. Do I think that crystals can be a tool in meditation? Do I think that they could help someone process trauma? That it is a tool in a toolbox that can be used spiritually? Yes. Physically, I'm not down with it. Yes, I'm a witch, I'm a spiritual person, but I also believe in science and medicine, and there's a time for place for both. You would go to a witch to heal a broken heart, you would go to a doctor to heal a broken leg.
This is how to make a really simple self-protection jar for baby witches or closeted witches. First, cleanse the bottle, add salt, add eggshells, add pine for grounding, add moon water or rain water. Add something personal for your own intent. Charge the jar. And seal it with candle wax. And there you have it.
Here are some things I wish people had told me about when I was starting my practice.
None of them are actually that important, they're just cool.
You can clear a space with sound. Bells and chimes are the best, but this motherfucker resonates with my soul.
You can take anything that you like and make it a part of your craft.
For me, that's Fleetwood Mac.
Also, you don't have to buy a whole bunch of expensive crystals to cleanse your space. In fact, TJ Maxx sells these little bad boys for $12. Go get you one.
If you read these bad boys, it is like 50% about what the meanings are and mostly about what your intuition says. No one told me that.
Most importantly, nobody can tell you how to do your craft. It is 100% based on your intuition and your relationship with your spirit guides.
Oh, look who controls all the islands. It's the Mahajapit, Majahapit, Mapajahit, Mahapajit, Mapajahit, Majapahit.
It's Gypsy. Welcome to my witchy camper. So many people want to know why I seal my spell jars, so here's my answer. I seal them to keep what's in, what's out. Dry cork is very porous, and I don't want anything twisting my intentions.
How how to tell if a crystal is fake.
Glass is often sold as clear quartz. Clear quartz does not magnify writing. Glass does. Anything that's one perfect colour all the way round is fake. This actually is selenite, but it's been dyed. If you buy chunks like these, make sure they have rock on them somewhere. Even this fairy cavern has rock in it where it wasn't able to be fully cleaned out. If your clumps aren't rocky, they're probably fake. This is really common with amethyst for some unknown reason, but when you do look at the rock, look along the seam where it just meets the crystal, because sometimes you can see glue, where they've glued plastic fake amethyst to plastic fake rock. When you buy crystal balls or crystal points, always check for air bubbles. If it's got air bubbles, it's fake. Swirly bits are good though. If it's heavy, it's more likely to be real. It's just too perfect, it's fake.
My mom let me have a rose petal for Mother's Day.
Why do you need rose petals, Liana?
Well, baby,
rose petals have many uses.
You can carry them in your pocket to attract love.
Look, the inside of a rose is like a sea star.
You can boil the leaves and make rose water. Who doesn't love rose water? You can make potpourri.
The potpourri.
You can make a tea with it to encourage doing the nasty.
Taking a bath with rose petals can also help increase your female intuition. Not only will it smell good, but it'll also help attract love, good luck, and health.
Also, if you spread some of the petals around the house, it could also help relieve some tension.
Wake up and smell the roses.
So, you know how I've been practicing witchcraft for like a whole week now?
Only a week, yeah.
Yeah, like a whole week. It's crazy, right? So anyway, I did a spell.
Oh, already? Have you researched the materials and topics I gave you?
Well, no. I thought that was really boring and I just wanted to like jump right into it, you know? So I did a love spell.
Excuse me?
Yeah, I did it on my ex and something really bad happened.
Oh my gods, did you at least cast a circle?
I don't know what that is.
What happened?
So I did the spell, and then 2 days later, he ended up in the hospital for unknown causes.
What was the spell?
Well, I just found it on Tumblr, and it said that I had to burn a picture of him.
So you tried to do a love spell, and the person you wanted to do it on, you set on fire?
Can you help?
No, I don't get paid enough for this.
Need to cleanse, but you got asthma? Make spray. First thing, get you some water. Doesn't have to be moon water. You can use tap, whatever you have. Next, you need some salt, blessed by a German shepherd. Very important. Bay leaves. Recipe called for one bucket. Then you're going to get a handful of rosemary and a handful of sage. Now, we are going to shove that shit in there. I know I should have used a glass container. They're all in use. Don't come for me, sis. Now we're going to add the water in. Pretend it's wine and just pour the whole thing in there. Now, close the cap. Make sure your cat is judging you. It's a very important part. Shake it up. Blend it all together. The more he judges you, the better it will work. Now put in a cool, dry place, let it steep for a couple days, and give your dog a damn treat, you monster.
I'm going to show you how I reuse candle containers. First, you're going to boil some water, then pour it inside each container all the way to the rim. The hot water is going to melt the wax and start to bring everything to the top. The wax will separate from the water, looking like oil on the surface. As the wax is cooling, it's going to start to pool and solidify at the top of the water. Once the wax has cooled, you can push it in with your finger and it'll come out as one piece. I pulled mine out a little early, so it kind of came out like a glob. This candle was a little more cool, so it came out as a harder chunk. Then just wash out your containers with soap and water.
Fuck you, goat man!
Holy shit, dude.
Is that good?
I thought you were gonna build your way up.
No. I just right out of the gate. Why build up?
If you don't believe, then there's nothing for you to be afraid of, right? You could be as big a prick as you want. I'll stand over here.
Goat man, I'm dancing on.
Hey everyone, welcome to Rapid Changes that started happening when I discovered I was a witch. First, I got absolutely addicted to crystals. This is my first tray out of three. You heard me, three. I have a budget for crystals now. Next, I have things drying absolutely everywhere. I have fruit peels, I have herbs. They're all over my house, they have invaded. I also have literally dried fruit hanging up. Next, I started getting addicted to plants. I have so many now. I think I have over 50 plus a full-fledged garden in my backyard. The plant addiction was real and it was very expensive. The next thing that happened was the absolute addiction to having incense burning anytime I am anywhere. When I became a witch, I also started hoarding anything that might be useful in spells, including dyeing flower petals, leaves, any kind of sticks I found. And lastly, the absolute addiction to jars and having them absolutely everywhere. And look, more herbs drying in random places. And lastly, I got weirdly addicted to bones. I have a lot of them now, and that's...
I'm not a witch. Not a witch. Nope. You know, pretty witchy, but I'm not. My bundles? Nope, just because I have this doesn't mean I'm a witch. I can't believe you still assume I'm a witch.
Yeah, no, I'm still not a witch.
No, I'm not a witch.
Nope. 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 I just really like teas.
Can't I just enjoy tarot cards?
Alright, maybe I am a witch.
Oh! This is awkward. Yes. What? It's here. Really, Marshalls? Oh, shit. Fuck. Really? Okay, I went out and bought new lavender. I really just can't catch a break, can I?